Hello everyone, welcome to this interview series where I have a master's student from Twente University in Netherlands. He is currently in his first year of master's in Twente University in Electrical Engineering faculty. So his name is Nishant Misra. If you have not seen him, you might find him in some of my previous videos. Before he came to Netherlands, he had some questions. He also gave some ideas for some of the videos which might have also helped you all. So I'll leave that in the info card and let's start the video now. So yeah, Nishant, you can give a short introduction about your academic background, where are you from, and then we can start with the questions. So this video will be focused on applying for electrical engineering in Dutch University in Netherlands based on his experience. And in the next video, we're going to discuss how is his experience of doing the master's program till now. So check the next video if you want to know about the experience now. And this is only before. So you can start, yeah. Okay.
Okay. So he wanted to know about my background. So I did my bachelor's in electrical and electronics engineering from GGS IPU or IPU University Delhi. And I did an internship of 1 year in one of the labs of IIT Delhi in the microelectronics department. And now I'm here at the University of Twente as a master's student of electrical engineering. And my specialization is lab on a chip systems.
Yeah. Okay. Okay. So why did you want to come to the Netherlands for master's in electrical and how did you find out about it?
I found out about the country of the Netherlands before I started looking into the options for studying here, but finally, like, my decision was influenced by like how they have a lot of semiconductor companies that are pretty good, known on the world stage, like ASML, you have Philips, and all the companies that were in the electronics field and also in the healthcare field, which is where lab on chip systems is. So that's why I chose to study here. Yeah.
Okay. So I know that the application requirements are always listed in that particular university's website in very detail, and you can also always apply online. Everything is digital. But still, can you highlight like maybe like in very fast or very briefly like what application requirements are there? Is there anything specific for applying for electrical in Twente University? And did you apply yourself or did you take help of any consultancy?
Okay, so I applied myself. It's a very easy process, and the university also has a representative in India that can help you with the application. And the application requirements were like you have to have like a first division in your bachelor's. You had to have your TOEFL score of, I think, above 90. And one particular thing that was different about University of Twente was that they required like 15 EC in practical stuff, like practical thesis work. That's where they needed like some small amount of credits. And apart from that, it's like a very straightforward process.
Okay. So you mentioned that they have a representative in India. So do they like offer that service for free or they charge something to give you like some advice or help?
Okay, so it's the office of the University of Twente. It's I think in Tamil Nadu, and they offer it for free. And I think applying to the university is also free.
Okay, so from any part of India, you can like just call yes. them or ask yeah. them if you have any additional questions. Okay.
Yes. Yes.
Okay, that's good to know. So how much time did you take to plan and apply for these positions or universities? So yeah, what was your timeline?
So my timeline was, for the whole application process was about more than a year. Because I had also applied 1 year before, and most of the time was just like looking at different universities, their application requirements, compiling all that, and then writing a customized SOP for each of the universities. So up and that was like going alongside with my internship and my studies. So it's like a little bit of time every week. So yeah.
So maybe like I think like in the final in the from the if someone wants to apply immediately after bachelor's, then they should like start looking or start preparing maybe in the third year, right? Like the ideal time.
Yes. Because you also
If
have
they want to start
to,
immediately.
yes. If you want to start immediately, you'll have to have your English test scores. That takes a while, and writing the SOP takes a while. So these are the two things that take the most time, I think. Other than that, you don't really need to have a lot of like time dedicated. If you have the university in mind, then it's not a big deal.
And do you think like the experience helps? Like for example, if you have any research internship like in IT or maybe a company you are working for 1 or 2 years,
Yeah, definitely. Like,
that, yeah.
yeah, research experience definitely helps. Like, even if you have like a conference paper or any experience in a lab, because here everything is connected to research, as you know. So, yeah, they really value that over just your grades. So that gives you like an edge over other applicants.
So did you get any scholarship? If yes, then how much? And how did you get it? Or if not, then how do you finance your studies?
Okay, so I don't have a scholarship, and my parents are financing me for the study from the savings.
So are there any specific scholarships that people get in 20 University, or like what is the number and what are the chances of getting it?
Okay, so I don't know about the chances of getting it, but you have the Holland Scholarship, the Orange Tulip Scholarship, and then there's another scholarship that the University of Trento itself gives. And I can't speak about all of the fields, but if you talk about the ITC, which is the International Training Center for Geoinformatics, they have a big proportion of students who have like a scholarship. So 80% or like 60 to 80% of the students there have a scholarship if you're applying in that specific field.
And how is it like a partial amount or is it full?
As far as I know, the scholarships that the people at the ITC have, they are like fully funded, and there's also scholarships that are just for the first year of your study.
Okay,
So partial and
so
fully both.
okay, maybe we can leave a link in the description below if anyone wants to have a look at that website or something. So, do you want to give any advice for students who want to apply for 20 university masters in electrical?
So my only advice would be to prepare yourself for like with if you have any opportunity to do any research work, go for that, and just like focus on like practical stuff. Apart from that, like if you're talking about the admission process, it's like very simple. It's just like they will tell you what documents you need, and you just have to upload and send them. And the team in India is like pretty supportive of the whole application process. Another thing that might take time would be like getting your degree and getting your transcripts right off, right as you graduate. And that's something that you have to also look into. So for your documents and all.
Okay, thank you, Nishant, for such a quick and nice information for people who are we are planning to apply for 20 University in future for Masters in Electrical. And check the next video if you want to know about his experience in the first year till now, what he experienced in that university. So till next video, see you, bye from Netherlands.